Welcome back. In this Safe Search lesson, I'm going to show you how to use the email function to add email notifications to your Safe Searches. So let's take a look. All right, so we're back again to item fulfillment pending but not shipped. That's the Safe Search I showed in the previous lesson. And over here in the subtabs, we have email. So let's click on that and scroll down. So all right, there's kind of two basic things you can do with emails. You can either send emails when there's, so let's say the Safe Search, you know, in this case, it was the items for pending fulfillment but hasn't been shipped. You can specify that now when something, when either something in that Safe Search has changed or when a new item has hit that list, an alert suddenly gets sent out. So let's say you're the only person that's being notified. An alert would go to you saying this new item fulfillment number that's now listed as picked, but not packed and shipped. So it would send you that notification. So that's one category of things. That the notifications or the alerts, that would be more appropriate for things where it's a high priority or some kind of a sensitive issue. So maybe it's a purchase order that's over a certain value, or even it could be a very good priority thing, like certain sales orders that come through that are over a certain value and you want to know about that. Or maybe you have certain accounts set up that you don't want, there's just no reason that any general ledger impact should happen on that account. So you set it up so that if anything does hit that account, an alert is generated and would go out so that you can kind of immediately be aware of that. So that's the alerts side of things. The second thing you can set up is the scheduled email, kind of like update reminders. And that's just a recurring thing that you're setting up. And that would be more used for example, you want the sales team to notify the management body of the sales for that week or for that month or even for that day. You could send them an email that would go at a recurring schedule, and it would have, oftentimes in that case, it would have like an Excel grid or a CSV file attached that would include maybe all the sales orders that came through, or maybe it's a generation of all the new leads that they've gotten, and it can be emailed. Again, you can email it to the executives for the company, you can email it to other people in the company, however you want to do that, but it's a recurring thing. It's not like a one-off, this is a priority alert going out. So the way that you're going to see these is this checkbox is if you want to have it sent out as an alert, and if you click over here, this is more for according to a schedule, and it auto clicks these two. This is specifying that if there's no results, like for example, it's like new leads for the day, and you know the email's going out every single day, even if there's no new leads, it will still send an email out. That might be annoying depending on the situation, so you can unclick that if you want. You also have summarized schedule emails. This is basically saying, let's say there was like 50 sales orders in an email that goes out saying these are all the sales orders for the day. That would not just send as one email, it would send an email based on every single sales order, which can be useful in certain specific cases. But in general, again, if you're sending a lot of data, you would not want every single instance to be sent. So you would want it to be summarized. So we'll leave that selected. So now that we've got this kind of setup, we're gonna show you first just a kind of a scheduled setup. We get to the recipients. So in this case, we can add anyone. We can add customers, we can add contacts, we can add employees. So you can see we have the whole gamut of people. So let's send it to Carol Morgan. So we're gonna add her, and we're also gonna add Catherine Glass. Now, these are employees, so in their record, it has their email address. So we don't necessarily need to put the email in. It already, you do need to make sure your employee records have the emails attached to them. But as long as that's set up, it will automatically know where to send these emails. So we're gonna add her. And the next kind of sub, this is a sub list. So the next one we're gonna go to is custom message. And if we click on that, it gives us a little disclaimer up here. You can read that to kind of get the full debrief, but you're basically stating if you don't fill anything out here, it will automatically, it'll kind of give you the Safe Search name and I think like a little blurb when it sends an email out. But if you want, especially if you're making a kind of a recurring email that let's say goes to management, you're going to want it to clarify and have a little bit of a something they can read when they open it, so it clarifies what they're looking at. So you can specify who it's from. If it's from you, you can put your name there. You can put the header line on the email, that's the subject, and you can have a little introduction to it, and then you can put additional data. So you can write that all in there, and then you can have it send within the message. So let's say it's taking those four items. You can either have those four items copied in the message of the email. So it's just an email and it'll have kind of this hodgepodge of you know, the item, the number, the customer kind of just plopped in there in the email. Or you can have it sent as an attachment that would be like a CSV file, Excel. You can also include a PDF if that's appropriate for what you're doing. CSV is probably the most common, but in the other example I gave, so you can do recurring emails and you can also do alerts. If you're doing an alert and it's really just kind of a one-off, like one thing happens and you want to notify people, so an email goes out, it sometimes is appropriate to just click send within message because it will just have one record. So that's easy to see in the body of a message, and that way you don't have to open an attachment. You'll just immediately see there what the thing is that you're being alerted about. So that's kind of the breakdown of how you want to send that. If we go back up here, the last thing I'm going to show you is schedule. So this is just specifying, again, for a recurring email going out, you're going to specify how are you seeing that, right? If it's just a one-off alert, it might just be a single event. But if it's a recurring thing that happens every day, you repeat what day. Maybe you just want it to happen on the weekdays and not on the weekends. Maybe you want it to happen weekly. And every kind of one you go down, weekly, monthly, yearly, you're simply going to be given more options as to exactly what time of the month is this going out. And then specifically what time it's going out. So what's the literal time of day? And you can also click here to specify when did these recurring emails end. If you don't want them to end, they'll, in other words, go on as long as that safe search is set up, you can simply click no end date and they'll continue going until you change them. So once we have all of this set up, right, we've got some recipients, we've got, we've specified, you know, you can add what is your custom message and put in a schedule, and you can hit save and run. And it'll take you back to the save search. And now we've set up this schedule where these recurring emails will go out, giving that specific save search to those recipients. And that's it for the email feature in save searches. I'll see you in the next video.